How long have you been working on this piece?
2-3 months.
Okay, good. Yeah, technically you're up to this piece. Okay, very good control. Okay, clean, good tone. So now let me ask you a question. Do you like to sing? You sing?
No, not really. I like to whistle.
You sing?
I can, if you want me to.
Can you sing this song?
No.
This is song exactly the song that you need to sing.
Okay.
Yeah. Because right now, I think the thing is with your playing right now, your phrasing is too stiff. You need to work on the phrasing a little bit. Okay. You say you want to sort of a master class, so let's spend like 15 minutes and work with you a little bit. Okay, let's start from beginning. Okay, let's start from beginning. Right now you have two similar phrase, right? See, we don't live our life twice the same way. We don't even get to live our life twice, right? So you step on the water, you never step on the same spot. These two phrases, you need to be, one of the phrase have to be different from another. You have to think about, if you play the first one or the on time, the next one you can take it free. The next one, then do something different. So don't play two phrases the same way, because that I don't know what's the word to you, but it's kind of boring to do it this way. Okay. Yeah, you have to try to think about color or maybe different phrasing to that. Okay. Yeah. So then after this, the skill is pretty good. That's one thing I don't understand. Can you keep on playing?
I listen to several,
uh-huh.
Or not like over and over again, but I've listened to several over time. So,
yeah. Okay, my own playing is I don't usually listen to other players. I listen to pianist. I my wife's a pianist, and then my teacher, my former teacher, is a great fan of pianist music. So he always asked me to listen to pianist and listen to the phrasing and how they phrase the music, right? And when you have this, when you have this piece, basically have two layers. You have melody, you have accompaniment. So you have to think about the accompaniment like you have a piano accompaniment doing it. Boom, da, ba, da, boom, da, boom, da, boom, da, boom, da. If you listen to pianists play all this accompaniment, they're not very steep, they're not like boom, da, boom, da, boom, da, boom, da. They have a little, they do a little thing like they stress the phrasing and then, you know, contract. So that's something you probably can come listen to singer, see how they do it, and then and do it in this piece. Because this piece is a very romantic piece. Okay. It's I think the phrasing should not be so stiff. Okay, can you try one more time? Let's follow my thing. The same thing. If you understand this part, you understand the later part. They're all the same idea, right? Yeah, it's very hard to break away from the habit. You know, it's easy to count. See, I think guitar is much harder to play than piano. Piano, they play, they move their hand. Guitar, because we have to think of the this coordination, right? So we have a tendency to think block by block. We don't think about the big picture, like the horizontal phrasing, all that. But I think that's what makes playing special, is you have that. You can play like that. Yeah, you have that to kind of make the spirit of music came up. Okay? You can just try to play.
Okay.
Everything's end. So you have the not good singer. Then you go into the it's the end of phrasing, right? So you can take time. You don't have to play. You don't have to play so in time. See, okay, the end of rape. Yeah, I cannot sing. Yeah, can you play from there? Okay, a little slower. But you don't want to. Okay, music have to have direction. So, where this thing go? It go to the top note, right?
Yeah.
And then going down. So you have the first mountain you need to climb is the top note. Da 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 da. Yeah, can you? Yeah, find the direction. Okay. You want to work on the phrase a little bit? Let's go. Start a little slow. Start a little softer, a little slower. Don't. Okay. So that G is your higher note, right?
Yeah.
That is your louder point. But you still want to have a good sound. Yeah, even if you play it loud, you still want to have a good tone. Yeah. Yeah, try one more. build up. Okay, build up to that point. Then after that, everything is downhill. And you just bring it to another phrase. Keep going. Okay, so da da di da di da da di da da. You got a da da, right? See the direction of the phrase. Da 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 di da di da da di da da. Right? So da da di da di da da di. That D. Okay. Don't start too loud. Da da da. It should be the same volume as the C you play. Da da, okay. Da di da di da.
Too
much. Okay, what's the G doing there? You know what G I'm talking about? Da da. Okay, the G, the bass.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you play? Not melody. I don't care about the G. That's not melody. That's the bass. I'm closing da da da. Before I think the da da the D, I didn't sing the G. The G is not melody. You don't need to play it so loud. Yeah. No, that G. That G I'm talking about.
Which one?
The, that one.
Oh, okay.
That's not melody. One more time. That's it. Just the G doesn't need to be there. It doesn't have to be loud. Because it's not a melody.
Okay.
Yeah, you perform. It's basically like you're giving a speech. You need to know the idea. What you want your audience to listen to. So I'm not saying that G is not important, but it's not necessary to play it loud. It's got to be there to provide the bass, but you don't want to play it loud so it take away the attention of the audience. You want them to hear the melody. This piece is very simple. It's very simple. It's like you have a singer singing and an accompaniment. That's it. So, but the accompaniment can never overtake the singer. So the accompaniment don't play too loud. Can you? Yeah, 1 minute. can you connect them? Make it sound like a phrase that I am going, taking you from here, from this part to here. So this is not a chunk of a chunk. This is to be a connected idea, organic idea. Okay. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Everyone is different, okay? But I'll tell you what I would do. Okay. I'll tell you, if I play this song, I'll rush this part. I'll go here and connect it to, and then make this a big frame instead of a chunk, like one beat by one beat. You're at high point. You should keep the same,
okay,
the intensity. Okay, keep going.
Longer.
Not longer. I mean, this one. Maybe rush a little bit toward here, and then you have time to slow down. You have time to slow down here.
Okay.
What this?
Alright, I got it.
Stay there, right? Just play this note as beautiful as you can, okay? And this block is a group of things become a not organic like a phrase. Understand how to do this one section, right? The other phrasing is pretty much. You just have to. Also, but you have three sections. Try to put each section a little bit different character or different column. Okay. Yeah, I run out of time, and I need to write your comment
okay.
sheet. So yeah. So,
thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Good playing. Okay. Your playing is really good. So the next level is to come. So you bring out the spirits of music. Not
okay.
just the what on the page. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh.